Welcome to rigor.com. In this video, we will discuss about how to use Testrigor for our automation testing need. When we are working on web-based automation or desktop-based automation, Testrigor is the best tool. I can see that we can use it on simple, plain English. So we can automate a number of processes by using Testrigor with plain English. So you can see this is the website name where we have to enter our credentials. So right now I'm using my own credential for login. And then post that we can use Testrigor for our automation requirement. Now, post entering the credentials, I'm into Testrigor suit page where we can create our own suit. So this is my old created test suit, which I have created 4 test cases and executed successfully, which I've already covered on the detail in the previous video. So if you're new to this channel, consider watching last video from Testrigor playlist. So for creating a test suit, we have to enter the name of the test suit. Let's say I'm entering here test demo, and post that we have to select the type of testing, which type of testing we are going to perform. Right now, I'm more into desktop web testing or mobile web testing or native or hybrid mobile web testing. These 3 options are available. I'm proceeding with desktop web testing. Here we have to enter the credential or the URL. So right now I'm going to use this URL. So this is my URL, and post that I have to enter the credentials which is needed for login of this page. So right now I'm going to log in with these credentials like admin and admin 123. So admin is my username and admin 123 is my password. Operating system, I am using Windows. So because of that, I'm selecting Windows. You can select any number of operating system which is available, Ubuntu or OXX. I'm going to use Chrome browser. Because of that, it's Chrome. Now, what we can do, we can select generate test automatically based on the auto dictionary. So as of now, by default, it's 10, but you can increase the number totally depending on the license to license. So as of now, I'm proceeding with 10 number. Post that, we have to click on create test suit. Post clicking on it, you will see the screen. Here, your test suit will be created. And right now, we are into that test suit. If I want to create a test cases here, so I can simply go and click on add custom test case and proceed further with my testing or automation requirement. Here you'll find it out before test suit and after test suit. If any prerequisites are there, we can define it here. Now let's add some test cases. Test case, then we have to go to the site and click on this tab. This will record all of your actions which you will perform post starting recording. So let's add candidate 3 here and click on start new recording. So post doing that, you can see this is auto populated here. The icon is blinking. So if you want to create a test case, do whatever actions you are doing manually. It will record all your actions and perform actions in automatically. Now, here we want to add a candidate for recruitment. We'll go to the recruitment menu bar, and I'm just doing over here. I'm not clicking anything, and it will display the candidates. So here I am clicking on candidate. You will find it out all these candidate detail available here. Now we are going to add a candidate, new candidate. So I am giving here test second rigor and demo 2. Email ID, I am going to use my same email ID which I am using. Phone number, I am going to add this phone number. And the job vacancy, I am giving here associate IT manager. I am not attaching resume as of now because there is no validation here. There is a mandatory field, only mandatory field is email here. So in keyword sections, I am adding just testing. In comment section, I am giving here NA, which is not. Date of application, I am selecting 15 as of now at today's current date. And consent to keep data, I am checking here. Post that, I will perform save option. And you can see successfully saved message available here. Either we can capture successfully saved message or the name of the person which we have added. So right now we are going to capture this name because we have just added. So after performing all this, go to this tab and click on stop recording. Now here you will find it out whatever actions we have performed is recorded. So before running that, first cross verify it with our provided code informations or with the resource code information. So let's check it and then we will do or run this code. So you can see here, enter admin into login panel or enter these details. I'm not going to use it here because this is auto doing login. So I will remove all this because we have already configured in our test suite. So it's not required to enter again and again. I will do here just login. Now it will click on candidate. So we are not going to click on candidate. Before that, we have hover action. So hover, then space, and then the as it is name I'm copying from here. So it's recruitment. In uppercase recruitment and then close double quote. Post that, I'm going to click on candidates, then click add section and enter the test into first name, which is the test you can see here, then rigor into middle name and the demo into last name. I'm using my same email ID into email and the contact number to same. Here we have selected job vacancy, selected associate IT manager, date, comment till comment, we are good. So click date of application below. So I'm going to remove this. I'm just copying enter into check the format of date from here. So 2021-08-15. So this is the date format which we are going to enter into date of applications. So we are going to remove this complete component from here and I will remove this one as well. Now I will check, click on consent to keep data and post that we are going to verify the name. So click first save. This is also required. Here we are going to verify the scroll down until page contains and we're going to verify this name. Now you can see same detail we have entered into the field, but here we are going to perform click We'll remove here this sections, and I'm keeping select associate IT manager from job vacancy. And post that we are giving here testing into keywords. Now we are done. Click on add and run. Once we'll click on add run, it will start executing the test cases inside our test suite. You can see it's in progress. So let's go to our test cases and see. Here, this is our test case detail, which is still running. Once you'll click on this icon, you'll find it out. Each and every screenshot will be kept here. So let's wait for the complete execution. You can see it entered the detail and logged in. We have removed the login credentials from the script. Then also it took it from our test suite. Now, post that you will see all these screenshots are generated. It's reached till click add. Now it is searching for our complete detail, entering the first name, middle name, last name, and then consent to keep the data. It will scroll out until page contains test trigger demo 2, which is accurate. Now you can see my test cases are executed and status is okay. It means we have completed complete execution. So if you can see this flow, it's very simple. We are just doing a manual work once, and next time onwards, we'll execute our test cases whenever it is required. So if you can see here, edit test case, when I will jump to the edit test case, if I will need any modification in the future, then also I can modify it, which is very simple to modify it. And once I will done, update and rate it, test it. Here, if I want to run this test case again, then definitely we are going to perform it by using retest actions. If you want to see complete screenshot, you can see it on clicking any of the image from captured screen. Whenever it is needed, delete any of the test case. We can directly delete it from here. Now you can see there are various test cases I've created by me is listed here. We have ran it multiple times. Apart of that, creating test cases from here, we can also create or add custom test case from here. Simply click on that, provide the description of your test case, enter all of the steps required, click add and run, which is simple enough to run any specific test case. So by using test trigger test suite, I can see our automations requirement will become very easy. We don't need to depend on any vendor for do automation activity of any organizations. Even we can buy it, and all of the codes are written in a simple language or simple plain English language so that we can automate our stuffs within clicks, or even we can automate all of the tests sold within 4 to 5 days. Even I think it's doable for more than 200 test cases in 4 or 5 days, which is simple enough. We are doing very, very well automations, and we can modify it. When we want to run it, we'll also get a run notification on our email so that we can verify our test suite is passed or failed. If we want to run any specific test case, we can directly go here and run it. Otherwise, if we want to run complete test suite, we can also perform complete test queues execution. We have several filter options like all statuses or field or new test case status. We can also see that. If we want to search with any keywords, we can also do that from here. We'll do also have before test suite. If any prerequisites are there, we can also include it from here, which is again a simple enough for doing automation by using test trigger. Hope you liked it. If you really enjoyed this session, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. Thank you for watching.